Do you believe that the 2020 election result was legitimate?
It was not legitimate. Anybody with a half a brain knows that.
This was not a legal loss. It was stolen illegally. They cheated.
I have a background in statistics, and I know it's not, it doesn't make sense.
I think it was stolen, and we're totally scared it's going to be stolen again.
And who do you think is responsible?
Unelected bureaucrats in collusion with the media, big tech.
You guys are delusional, and you're not really delusional. You know your boss won't show anything. He won't let me say Dominion, Smartmatic, ES&S.
If you're a bad guy, you're going to say, I don't see it, la, 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 I don't see nothing. But if you're a true patriot, and you know, what's right is right, what's wrong is wrong. But they don't, because they serve Lucifer. They serve a satanic god.
We're in Phoenix, Arizona. It's one of the states that swung the election to the Democrats in 2020. But it's since become an epicenter of election fraud conspiracy theories that have spread across the U.S.
Fact, foreign adversaries hacked America's election.
The amount of cheating was just mind-boggling, and we have them cold.
Almost one-third of Republicans running statewide in these midterms are running on election conspiracy theories. But here in Arizona, all four of the main candidates running statewide are running on the lie that the election was stolen in 2020.
You know, the mail-in ballots, or sometimes I will say things like the fake mail-in ballots, but I don't want to say that because it's so controversial.
Donald Trump may be the headliner today, but we're actually here to see Mark Finchem, the Republican running to become Arizona's next Secretary of State, meaning he would oversee elections here.
He's leading everybody. Everybody loves him because he's a warrior. Mark Finchem. Mark.
Finchem is a Trump loyalist and has been accused of anti-Semitism. He was present at the January 6th insurrection, spreading disinformation the day before.
When you steal something, that's not really a win. That's a fraud.
And in the aftermath, he's continued to spread disproven and unsubstantiated claims about the 2020 election.
Ladies and gentlemen, we know it, and they know it. Donald Trump won.
One of his central platforms is to heavily restrict mail-in voting, which has been secure and widely used in the state for decades. And inconveniently for him, it's also how he's voted for pretty much his entire life.
That's hey, Mark. Already been litigated.
Do you mind if we have a quick chat?
If you want to walk with me, but
I'll walk with
the
you.
Time I hit this, we're done.
So, Mark, you voted 28 times in the last 30 elections using postal voting, but you said you're against postal voting itself. Why is that?
Well, I voted in person this last time because of all the crap I saw that tells me
28
that election
out of the last 30 elections.
Yeah, yeah.
Isn't that
so
a bit hypocritical?
Point?
Isn't
what's
that a bit
point?
I'm asking if you think
what's
it's
your point?
Is
the point? The point is, in the last election, I recognized a problem, and I changed my voting behavior, along with a whole lot of people in Arizona.
How long has it been up?
Despite every lawsuit claiming fraud in the state failing, and even a sham audit in Phoenix determining no fraud, Finchem has been sticking by all his claims. He's also a longtime member of the far-right militia group, the Oath Keepers, many of whom were involved in storming the Capitol. I came out to rural Yavapai County to see a meeting with an independent chapter of the group.
It's absolutely swarming with militia people.
See, our security guy walking toward
that. Okay, room. Yeah. How many security have you got here?
We have usually about 10 to 12.
Okay. All with the Oath Keepers?
Huh?
All with the Oath Keepers?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's going on here is a combination of survivalism, nuclear preparedness, and election conspiracy theories.
A few things that I've asked you guys to get. Plastic to cover all your windows and doors to keep nuclear radiation or the particles from a nuclear bomb out.
This nation is divided. No two ways about it. That is leading to civil unrest and will eventually lead to a civil war.
Are there any countries that are very sophisticated with hacking and computers and IT wanting to control our elections here in the United States? No. Russia wouldn't want to do that. China wouldn't want to do that.
They have ruined Election Day in the United States of America. That's provable. And that's enough for me to fight the left with every fiber in my body.
One arm of this group call themselves the Lions of Liberty, headed by a member called Brian Muncy. and they were openly discussing their plans for poll watching at the election.
We cover as many hours as we can on these drop boxes to keep election fraud from happening. So we need volunteers. Please sign up. Help us stop the steal. And I'll leave you with this. We will not go quietly into the night.
We're calling it Operation Dropbox Watch. And we're going to, from the time the drop box is open until the election, we're going to have volunteers watching the drop boxes for fraudulent activity. I think the closest that we can get is 30 feet from a box. Mm-hmm. And we'll just monitor activity.
And you're going to be armed when you're doing that?
If you want to be armed, yeah. It's our legal right.
Turning up to a polling location objectively with a firearm, pretty intimidating. I would be, if I could vote in this country, I'd be pretty intimidated by that.
If someone's going to be intimidated by us carrying firearms, that's... We carry firearms in this county all the time. So if they want to view that as intimidating, that's their prerogative.
Armed poll watching might be at the more extreme end of election denialism, but the issue has become mainstream among Republican voters.
These are 3 for 5.
3 for 5?
What is that?
With polls indicating 70% of Republicans believe Joe Biden is not the legitimate president. And hearing about these plans left no illusions about just how extreme the fight for democracy in Arizona has become.
It's a lot easier when you're somewhere like Ohio versus like Arizona mountains.
And the Democrat trying to defeat Fincham is Adrian Fontes, a former US Marine and local election official. I came to meet him at a fundraiser in the Phoenix suburbs. And despite the opulent surroundings, many people here had grave concerns.
I have.
I'm glad.
Well, I lost a bunch of weight.
I know you were too thin.
And you, like my mom, were trying to get me to gain weight.
Yeah, yeah.
And so now I'm healthier.
And look what he did.
Am I in good shape? Good enough for you?
You're perfect.
All right.
I better win this election or I have to leave the state.
Oh, my gosh. Well, we don't want you leaving the state.
Definitely.
Is that how important it is for you?
Vancouver, Canada.
Vancouver? Really?
I know, all the Americans say they're going to go to Canada.
The situation is intolerable. And it's a cult. The Trump idolizers are in a cult. They are not rational, and it's very scary.
We left the fundraiser for a drive through the valley to a Democrat event on the other side of town.
What is the end game, though, just in a hypothetical world where Mark Fincham is the Secretary of State in Arizona? What is the end game? I mean, this is obviously something you're campaigning against, but you must have envisaged what the potential is for him.
His end game?
Yeah.
His end game is to install Donald Trump as the lifelong leader of the United States of America. Notice I didn't say president. Well, Trump wants to be a king. And he's got people like Mark Fincham who want to make him a king, which is absolute insanity to me. But that's really one of the most weird pieces of this puzzle is their sycophancy, their absolute undying loyalty to one person. Not an ideal, not a set of values, but one person.
I mean, I've spent a lot of time speaking to people at these rallies, speaking to people at Mark Fincham events. They believe it wholeheartedly. It is a lie, it's not true. But is there a way to sort of bring them back from that?
There's a certain amount of humility that you have to have, and there's a certain amount of grace that you have to offer when you recognize that there is someone who has been swept away. It's like people who get swept into a cult. There has to be a deprogramming. Everybody else in the world is seeing what they're not seeing. Everybody else in the world recognizes the flim-flam and the nonsense and the lies. But those people, man, they're sticking to it no matter what. And the more you try to talk them out of it, in many cases, the more they dig in their heels.
Although the race remains incredibly tight, it's clear that Fontes' candidacy is energizing the Democratic base. And part of that is to do with how direct the messaging has become.
This country in the past has sent its young men and women across oceans to die so that others would not have to live under fascism, so that they could breathe the same free air
that Americans have breathed. And right now in the United States of America, that same whip of fascism is arising. Right here in Arizona, a January 6th planner and insurrectionist wants to run the very elections that he would deny the legitimacy of. He's an oath keeper since 2014, and that means he and his group advocate for the violent overthrow of this government. It's bad for law, it's bad for medicine, it's bad for the arts and sciences, it's bad for education. There isn't a single thing good about electing Mark Fincham, and with your help, we're gonna kick his ass in a couple of weeks.
The race in this swing state could have real consequences, not just for Arizona, but for the rest of the United States when the presidential elections occur in 2 years. And given that importance, I wanted to try talking to Mark Fincham again. His campaign doesn't share many details about his public appearances, but I'd heard he was due to speak at another event in Phoenix. Despite the smiles on stage, around the back, he was in a very different mood. Hey Mark, it's Oliver with The Guardian again. We didn't get a proper chance to talk at the Trump event, so I just thought I'd see if you'd have
No, we had a plan. We had a chance to talk.
Spoke about 20 seconds.
Yeah. You were blathering bullshit, so...
Blabbering... I think I was asking you perfectly legitimate questions.
Well, no,
about
you asked me a question about 28 times that I voted.
Yeah.
Okay, so 28 times I had faith in the system. Mm-hmm. It was the 29th time that I no longer have faith in the system, so I changed the way I vote.
Do you not think it's
so? What's the problem with that? What do you have a problem with that? Well, I was convinced now that mailing my ballot was no longer a way for me to protect my franchise. Mm-hmm. Why do you have a problem with that?
Well, I guess a lot of people observing it might say it was slightly hypocritical to say that you wanted to take that opportunity and right away from other voters who wanted to vote.
So what, you guys are frauds.
What is your position on early voting then? Can you just tell me?
Frauds.
You don't want to.
The Guardian is a fraud. You are a fraud.
Okay. There you go. Guardian's a fraud, and he won't take any more questions.
Mark Fincham is doing his best to aggressively avoid scrutiny in this race. But despite the lies and exaggeration, it looks like the election will go down to the wire. Whatever the outcome, I felt like I was witnessing confidence in democracy being gradually eroded here. And the long-term consequences of that are far-reaching and ominous.